In our previous video, we showed you two DIY ways to decorate waste bottles at your home. And now, we bring you the part 2 with two more ideas to do so. The first method for bottle art today is the dot mandala method. For this, you would obviously require a bottle, glass or plastic. You would require gesso or texture medium, sponge, acrylic colors, some paint brushes of different sizes, cotton buds, a dotting tool or toothpicks, and maybe some 3D liners. So let's get started. So I've taken a glass bottle and now I'll be coloring it with some gray color. So I've mixed some black acrylic paint along with some gesso and then I'm dabbing it on the glass bottle along with the help of a sponge. And then I let it dry overnight. Once it's dry, this is how the bottle would look. Now there's a vertical joint line. We are going to keep this as the base point from which we are going to make the dots to create the dot mandala pattern. And to create these dots, we are going to use the back of different size of brushes and some Q-tips or cotton earbuds. Along with this, we will also be using a dotting tool. If you don't have a dotting tool, you can also use a toothpick. Now considering this vertical line that we are taking as the base, we are going to roughly mark a center and then put a big dot with some acrylic color of your choice. Then we are going to create some more dots of different size and different colors around it. You can also use the same size and same color if you want, but the more colors your mandala has, the more prettier it looks. The design that I am going to make would be basically around different shades of yellow and white. Now between the dots that you just made, put another line of dots of different size and different color. Keep on creating a circular pattern in this way by using different colors and different sizes of the dots. You could also create a designer pattern like petals also using the dots. So dot mandala design is basically nothing but just various sizes of dots and different colors coming up together to create a beautiful pattern like a rangoli or a mandala. Now you can either fill up the bottle by making such small designs all over, or like me, you can also go ahead and expand this design till it fills up the bottle completely. The secret behind making a uniform mandala is to just be patient and keep taking the color again and again so that all the dots are even. Doesn't the design look pretty already? But I'm going to expand it even more further. The shades that I'm using here are acrylic colors of Camlin, Indian yellow and golden yellow along with the white. And I've also mixed both of these yellow shades with white and got two different light shaded colors as well. So in total, there are 5 colors that are working in this mandala. If you wish, you can go ahead with a monochrome mandala as well. Or just 2 colors, 3 colors, or even multiple colors like a rainbow. Now you could also use some 3D liners if you want to just elaborate this design, but it's completely optional. So after filling up the bottle completely with dots, here is how the bottle looks like finally. You can keep it as it is, like a decor piece, or you can put up some artificial flowers or leaves in it and use it like a vase. And now we move on to the second and the last method of this series. This method is known as decoupaging, and the materials required for this would again be a bottle, but this time you would need a decoupage paper or tissue. some Mod Podge or decoupage glue, a jute lace and rope for decoration, a button and some glue. For this I'm using a glass bottle that I had painted earlier for another project, but it's been very long and now I'm going to reuse this. And I've got some decoupage paper. These are easily available at craft stores and online as well, so I'm going to leave out some link for you. Now we will be covering the bottle with this decoupage paper. So just wrap it around and then I'm going to cut the paper around the cut part because I intend to cover only this much portion with the paper. Now that this is done, apply some Mod Podge or decoupage glue on the bottle. Spread it with the help of a brush. Stick the paper from one end. And then wrap it around the bottle. Just stretch so that the paper is tight. Remove any air bubbles if in between. Now take some more glue and stick the paper on the other end. Now that the decoupage paper has been stuck, it's time to add some gloss to it. So again, pour some glue on the paper and then spread across with a brush. Decoupage paper and glue have a quality that when you wet the paper with the glue, it won't tear off. Unlike an irregular paper. And now let this dry for about an hour or two, and once this is dry, you will see that it has got a nice glossy shine. And now we are going to decorate it with some jute lace and rope. But this decoration part is completely your choice. You can use anything, any kind of lace, but overall the theme of this bottle is a little bit of a vintage kind of, so I'm using jute and burlap wrap and other stuff. And now your vintage style decoupage bottle is ready. You can just keep it like a decorative piece or add some jute doily flowers like I did to make it look like a vase. And here are both the ideas of today's DIY. And if you would like to check out my complete collection of bottle arts that I did till date, you can follow me on Instagram. The Instagram handle is mentioned somewhere on the screen, so do follow us on that and don't miss to check out our collection over there. But before that, please hit the like button, share with your friends, comment down below and subscribe to our channel for more such interesting videos.